as Guruji has told him, everything has to be perfect, na? So he goes and starts meditating. After 2 weeks, he comes back to him. What happened? What a trick you have told me. I was doing meditation for so long years. I was finding it difficult to sit for a minute into that complete peace state. But now here, you have told me this trick, and the monkey keeps on jumping in front of me the whole time I sit. I am not able to concentrate even for a fraction of a second, what for a minute. Every time I keep myself silent, the monkey comes in. Now why that monkey comes up? Because what I have to do? I have to stop that monkey from coming in. This is my target that is set. Similarly in the case of Pratyahar. If I put a negative target to myself, then it will always come into my mind. It will always keep on disturbing me. Instead, if I just observe what is happening, if I make it a positive observation that I have to observe this thing, I have to observe this camera, then automatically my vision over the AC, the fan and the lights will be lost. I will be concentrated on the camera. But if I say I don't want to observe this lights, I should not hear the fan hissing, I should focus only on the camera, then always it will be in the back of my mind what has to be excluded. So that exclusion never takes us to that inclusion state. So that's why in Pratyahar also, many of the times I while studying for this chapter over here, I went through various commentaries, and many of the times they have written restriction of the senses. But what I found when I went into the deeper meanings of the Sanskrit, what he has written, that he has not mentioned restriction. What he has said? He has said chitta swarupanukara. Swavishaya asamprayoga is happening and chitta swarupanukara is taking place, and that ego, that is called as Pratyahar. Hear what he says. See, swavishaya asamprayoga chitta swarupanukara eva indriyanam pratyahar. When I am focused over here, what is happening is this and this. Eva indriyanam pratyahar is saying. He is not saying that do indriya pratyahar and focus, then it becomes like I have to do. No, not that way. He is just simply putting it. Pranayam we are doing. We are going towards the chitta. Chitta swarupanukar we are doing. At that time, if we are focused on the chitta, then automatically the swavishaya asamprayoga will happen. And that what is indriyanam pratyahara. That is what is indriyanam pratyahara. And what is this pratyahara? Again, pratyahara is also, as I said over here, prati is to, ahara is towards ahara I am going. Many of the times pratyahara is understood negatively. Pratyahara karna hai. Nahi. No, it is prati ahara. And what ahara he is telling? Ahara he is defining. My ahara should be chitta swarupanukar. Got it? So it's a totally different lookout what he is putting forward. I will not say make a statement that it is falsely understood by any other people. I am not that great. But this is what I understand. If we take it very positively, it gives a very wider meaning. Because we have started a journey of Ashtanga Yoga to reach what? Chitta Vritti Nirodha. So firstly we have to understand what is Chitta. We have to understand what is the form of chitta, chitta swarupa. Then there will be chitta prasadana. And then it, even transcending even that, will go into the stages of dharana, dhyana, samadhi. That's why over here at Pratyahara, which is a very preliminary stage of dharana, dhyana, or dhyana to a more primary stage, this happens. that I am focusing towards my chitta, automatically withdrawal of my senses from the outward impulses takes place. So it has to be like a process that is happening. And when that ease comes, that time achievement becomes very easy. If I am keeping smaller targets, that's why when he is finishing pranayam, he is talking about what? He is not talking about pratyahar. He is talking about dharana. When he is finishing pranayam, he is saying dharana sucha yogyata manasa. He is not saying pratyahar sucha yogyata. Very clever man. It is like if I am going to reach the Everest, I am of course climbing the smaller mounts. And while, what happens while climbing the smaller mounts? What is pratyahar? So it is an inner process that is happening. It is focusing directly to dharana. And in that process, pratyahar is happening. Then he gives, what is the result of doing this pratyahar? Tata parama vashyate indriyana. After I have done this, I will learn how to control my senses, how to control my mind from getting attached to, because as I have explained, atma, sattva, indriya and artha is the chain of perception. Artha is what has to be perceived. Indriya is the sense organ which perceives. Sattva is the manas which creates a link between that indriya and atma. Atma is the final which perceives the thing. Okay? So as per Ayurveda also this is explained. This is the chain of gaining knowledge. So my manas is the important thing which has to be treated and made to understand how to gain knowledge in the perfect sense and where to control and where not to control. So it is like the training of that thing. Because my ear may be listening something, my eye may be seeing something, but it is not at every moment that I gain knowledge from every sense organ. That's why many of the times happen. Hey, you passed away from front of me, you didn't see me. Why such thing happened? Maybe at that time, I am coming over here to the help to give my lecture. The whole thing is in my mind that I have to talk about pratyahar. Any of my best friend walks from front of me, I may not perceive him. The image may be formed on my retina. The occipital lobe, it may reach. But I am not transcribing it. I am not analyzing it. If it was any other day, I had no hurry to come over here. I may have stopped him, even if he might have not seen me. I may have stopped him, talked to him. I may have perceived him. But that time my mind is not over there. My mind is somewhere else. We say na, mera shayad dimag mein kuch dusra chal raha hoga. So mera dhyan nahi gaya. Tumne awaaz di kya? When we get concentrated, what is concentration? In a particular subject, in a particular sense organ, when the mind is attached only in that particular sense organ, rest of the sense organs fall. So that selective perception or control over the senses is what we are going to achieve through pratyahar. Because till now what we have come through? Yama, niyama, social, personal conducts we have learned. Then we have learned asanas to create body consciousness, understand what is ourself, a complete human being. And then we have come down to pranayama, understanding of our breathing process and getting into that process of that movement of the prana. And prana not only up to the breathing, but the whole pranic energy that moves in the body. And then we are going into a state. Now we are moving still inwards. Because ultimately what we have to reach is chitta vritti nirodha. For chitta vritti nirodha, firstly we have to understand what is chitta. So pratyahar comes if we may talk about what is called as chitta prasadhana. Chitta prasadhana is also a big concept what Patanjali has talked about. So before chitta prasadhana,